What's good, YouTube? Jake here with Venter Visuals, and on this channel we discuss and break down popular and trendy video effects for music videos and creative edits. And today I could not be more stoked to be showing you guys how to create this easy glitch transition effect in Adobe Premiere Pro without using any third-party plugins. I'm not going to be using After Effects, no Photoshop, nothing. All you need is Adobe Premiere Pro to achieve this effect. So let's get into it, guys. So here in my timeline, you'll notice I already got the clips stacked up on top of each other. These are just clips from a music video I had to edit last summer for a client. So before we break it down from scratch, I'm just gonna open up this layer just to show you guys what goes into an effect like this. So as you can see, we're gonna be using Transform, Color Balance, HLS, Levels, and Turbulent Displace to get this look. So what I'm gonna do now is just copy paste these same clips over here, but without the glitch transition itself. So now we just have the standard, you know, music video clips, no glitch transition happening. So the first thing we wanna do here is come to this first frame of this second clip. And what we're gonna do is hit this camera icon that says export frame. You're gonna make sure that it imports into your project. I'm just gonna save this as cutout. We're gonna hit okay. And if you don't see this export frame icon right here, just go ahead and hit this plus on this button editor. And it will be in this area right here, as well as all the other buttons that you can place onto your toolbar. So pretty cool feature. So now that we've taken an image of this frame right here, I'm gonna go back to my project panel. So all I'm gonna do is drag this onto my timeline, line it up about where the cut in between the clips is. So as you can see, it's right here. And I'm just gonna cut this cutout JPEG right here. We lined it up at the very end of the first clip, and it's gonna lead us into this second clip right here. So as I scroll over it, you know, nothing's happening. We get a couple of those frames that are just kind of paused. So I'm just gonna tweak my view settings here so we can see this better. We want this to be about 8 frames long here of a glitch. So what we're gonna do is just drag this out about 8 frames. As you can see down there on the bottom right of my cutout, you can see how long we're dragging it out. So this is gonna be 8 frames right here. Boom. From here, all we need to do is go up here to our opacity tab, select this pen tool, and then we're just gonna come over here to the preview of our footage, and we're just gonna start kind of like roughly tracing him out of the background. This is what we call a mask, okay? So we're masking him out of the background right here. It doesn't have to be perfect. As you can see, I'm just kind of going along the bottom here, just kind of tapping along. Definitely not perfect by any means. If you do want to get a perfect outline of whoever you're tracing out, definitely check out some of my tutorials on rotoscoping that are on my channel. I'll include a link to some of those down below if you're interested in rotoscoping and After Effects. So after we're done tracing, you can see it just cuts them out right here. Now if I turn this opacity on and off over here, you can see we got him masked out perfectly how we wanted him. And now what we need to do is add in this glitch effect, okay? So what we need to do first is just right-click on our newly masked cutout, and we're just gonna hit nest, okay? So that's gonna enable us to make changes using the transform tool without messing up the masks, which brings me onto our first effect that we're gonna throw on this, which is the transform, okay? So we're just gonna type in transform and effects, drag that on. From here, we're just gonna add a keyframe on position and scale. We're gonna drag that to the very end so that he ends up at the spot where the next clip begins. And now here in the beginning, you know, we're just gonna start tweaking the position and the scale. We're gonna drag him around the frame a little bit. Depending on how extreme you want this glitch to look, this like glitch effect, you can do a ton of movement. You can keep them in the same area. You can move them all over the screen. It's not gonna matter if the cutout isn't perfect at the end of the day, because we're just gonna be throwing on more effects to give it that chopped up glitchy feel. Don't worry if your cutout isn't perfect. Like obviously my cutout is far from perfect, but you're not gonna notice it once we finish this effect. Okay, so as you can see here, I'm just moving the scale and the position. I'm just adding keyframes into this little area right here. And keyframes are just moments in time where we want the effect to start happening. So as you can see, he's just bouncing around there already a little bit. Now I do want to add some more movement, so I'm just gonna keep tweaking and adding some more keyframes here in between until we get a nice jittery type of motion. Once you do develop some keyframes here on the timeline, you can just copy paste them kind of wherever. So I'm just gonna highlight over these two, you know, we'll throw those in towards the beginning so he's back there in the beginning, and you get this more like staticky glitch effect a little bit easier because you're just copying and pasting keyframes. As you can see there, now we got him like kind of glitching all over the place. Now the beauty of using the transform effect instead of just keyframing the motion of this clip is that the transform has this effect on it called shutter angle. Now we're gonna turn this up to 360, and that's gonna give it some motion blur. Now obviously we gotta add that glitchy color effect into it. So what I'm gonna do here is come over to my effects panel, type in HLS, drag on color HLS into our timeline here, and as you can see it gets red because now we're using several different effects on the same clip, but that's okay. All we need to do is mess around with this hue and the saturation. So we're just gonna make a keyframe at that hue and saturation, drag it to the end, and then here in the beginning we're gonna turn the hue like crazy up, we're gonna turn the saturation way up, and we're just gonna make a few adjustments throughout the frame. As you can see now we get like already he's already got all these different colors, right? So what I'm gonna do is just keep tweaking these colors around with the keyframes, and so yeah, we get a nice like kind of flickery color effect going on. So now what we're gonna do is come back down to our effects tab, and we're gonna type in an effect called levels. We're gonna throw one of those puppies on there as well. We're gonna make a keyframe on white input level, drag it to the end, and now we're just gonna tweak this white keyframe level so that we kind of get like a flickering going on during all of this. So as you can see, we can really manipulate our cutout right there. And again, I'm just gonna take these keyframes that I'm making and just copy paste them around the timeline here. So as you can see, now we kind of get like this flickering brightness going on with the effect. And what we're gonna do now is come down here to our effects tab and we're gonna type in turbulent displace, okay? So what we're gonna do now with this turbulent displace is change it from turbulent to horizontal displacement. We're gonna turn the amount really far up, maybe to like, let's go to like 3000, boom, perfect. So it looks like that. And then we're gonna turn the size all the way down, okay? So like to 2 right here. So now we're getting that glitchy look right there. Now you can mess around with the complexity and all of the evolution of things if you want more like static going on with this effect, but I'm just gonna leave that as is. We're gonna keyframe the amount, the size, the complexity, and we're gonna drag these keyframes to the very beginning because I've already manipulated them. And then we're just gonna hit the reset parameters here at the very end so that everything resets to how he's supposed to look right there at the end. And as you can see, we're getting like this crazy look right here already. So this is just because we have it set to turbulent instead of horizontal displacement, which I thought I changed, but I didn't. So you can play around with all these right here. As you can see, whenever we switch these turbulent displacement effects, we're gonna get a different look. This is what I wanted, horizontal displacement right here. And now you can see he's kind of glitching all over. But we don't like how he kind of just comes out of it right there at the end. We want him to stay glitchy until the next frame. So what I'm gonna do is just increase the amount back here up to like 4,000. So there's a keyframe. And then I'm gonna also change the size back down to 2 and make a keyframe there. So it doesn't go right into back to regular right there at the end, right? So we have it staying glitchy for a good second. Now when I render this back, we should have a really nice looking effect. So you'll notice that we're not getting the motion blur that we turned on in the transform. And that's because we have use composition shutter angle turned on, right? So all I'm gonna do to turn motion blur kind of back on for this effect is to just uncheck this box. And that's gonna give us more blur. Now this is up to you guys. Obviously it's a cool look to have it turned on as well. And so, you know, the choice is up to you, but it is cool that you can get somewhat of a motion blur type effect using the transform effects right in Adobe Premiere Pro. So either way, if you want motion blur, cool. If not, you know, check the box. So now when we play it back here, we should see the final result. Boom, right there. I'm kind of not a fan of how this kind of comes out squiggly here at the end. So we're gonna leave the glitch happening here at the end, and what we need to do to fix that is just take out these last keyframes for turbulent displace. That's just gonna enable it so that it doesn't really come out of the glitch effect, and it's not gonna have that weird squiggle line that we just saw there. So let me render this out real quick and we'll take a look at it now. All right guys, so here it is with the actual music behind it. So, yeah, I think that's really dope. And for these like high energy trap edits with a lot of effects and transitions, like this is a really cool effect to have here in Adobe Premiere Pro. So now that I'm done with this effect, I can actually save this as a preset by holding command on my Mac, and I'm gonna right click all of these effects that I used on this nested sequence, and I'm gonna hit save preset. I'm gonna keep the type on scale. I'm gonna change the name to like glitch preset, and I'm just gonna hit okay. So now if I want to add this effect a lot faster for the next time I want to use like a glitch type of effect. So say we want to use it, you know, here at the beginning of this clip down here, you know, maybe I'll cut it right there. So we'll use it on this part of the clip. So we'll come over here to a presets. There it is, glitch preset, drag that on. And it should give us our glitchy effect, which obviously it's not gonna load in right here because there's a lot of effects thrown on. So what I'm gonna do is just render this little sequence. All right, so as I scroll over it now, you can see we get the effect. Now, this is clearly a lot of glitch happening here, but you get the point. We would need to adjust this first transform frame right here. So maybe we just reset this first frame in scale so that it doesn't look like it's out of the frame like that. And now we have like this kind of like glitchy transition without seeing the border. So if I render this back out, render into out. All right, so here we go in full motion. Now this is gonna be the first effect we made, and then it's gonna show the clip after which we use the preset on. So check this out. So pretty dope way to just make your own glitch transitions and then also just incorporate some masking in for your own types of like cutout transitions. So it's kind of an easy way to kind of get the rotoscope look without using After Effects. And I really like this effect just because it's quick, it's easy, and it's pretty flashy. If you guys have any questions at all about this effect or just video effects in general, please comment them down below. I'm happy to help everybody who comments on my videos. And I'm very excited for what's to come on this channel. You guys responded very well to my last video, Top 7 Music Video Effects, and it's gotten me really stoked this week to just kind of polish stuff up and get ready for the next phase of Venture Visuals in this journey. So just been super focused on coming out with some new products and refreshing the website. I've actually been working a lot on this texture overlay pack, which is perfect for music videos and any type of creative edit really. And if I just scroll through here, you know, I've actually teased this in one of my other videos as well, so you might have already gotten a little sneak peek of it. But yeah, I got some really cool like textures on here for music videos. It took me a long time to just research and come up with how to make some of these. And I also did a lot of experimenting and just thinking practically and creatively about how I would want, you know, overlays to look and how I would feel if I got this pack and, if, you know, am I going to use this pack in the future on my own videos. So I spent a long time on it because I really did want to create something that was authentic to Venture Visuals without copying other people. So, you know, it did take me a while to come up with some of these ideas. Obviously the glitch ones, a lot of people have glitch packs out on the internet, but you know what, I wanted to throw in some of my own unique glitches into this pack because I use glitches a lot for transitions and overlays. So this is gonna be my texture overlay pack, which is dropping very, very soon. And then I'm also going to be dropping a Photoshop cinematic titles pack. So as you can see here, I've got 25 titles ready to go. Basically just made a bunch of templates for cinematic title screens and title intros, just keeping in mind music videos and just cinematic visuals. I designed all of these title screens here, which you can download and use in your own edits and just overlay them on top of some footage. So I'm very excited about these because a lot of them are really clean and I'm definitely using some of these on my own music videos in the future. And I spent a lot of time working on this pack as well. I actually just finished it this morning. So I'm very stoked to be dropping this on the website as well. And I'm definitely gonna be including some of these in the free pack, which you can find on my website on venturevisuals.com. So if you are interested in adding some sauce to your visuals, definitely check out my website. I'll include a link below. And I appreciate all the love, all the likes, all the subscribers, everybody who comments on my videos. Thank you guys so much. You're the reason I keep doing this. And I'm very excited for what this year holds for this community and all of us who are trying to get better at video editing. So I appreciate it, guys. Thanks again for watching my video. Until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out.